So the iPhone 14 is rumored to come with either Face ID being under the display or a smaller notch, maybe not a notch per se. Speculation says that the iPhone 14 would have a hole punch or a pill shape cutout, or both of them. We don't know yet. Also, guys, we have a confirmed date for the Samsung S22 Unpacked event, which we'll be sharing very soon, shortly in this video. Again, TECNO is making a telephoto camera. They're also making the first sensor shift camera for Android. Hey, what's up, guys? It's Fisayo here, and welcome to 2022. In this video, we'll cover all of the new tech updates that have happened in the past couple of weeks, past couple of days, and some exciting stuff that I've seen. Also, I'm going to cover what we should expect to see with regards to smartphone tech in 2022. If you're new here, welcome, and if you're returning, welcome back. I'd love it if you could hit that like button so more people can benefit from the knowledge that we'll be sharing in this video. All right, welcome to Tech This Week. And without further ado, let's get to the video. First things first, the iPhone 14 and maybe the 14 Pro. The iPhone product cycle definitely falls under the September, October slash rare November period, but we can't ignore, you know, those leaks and rumors that we've seen coming out every time. There are many of them. The first one is the iPhone 14 getting a 48 megapixel camera on the back. iPhones typically, you know, have 12 megapixel sensors on the back, but this time around, there are rumors pointing to us getting a large 48 megapixel camera with a periscope zoom, basically the zoom feature that we have on the S21 Ultras of the world. And also, guess what Apple takes from the S21 Ultra? Yes, 8K recording. These are two features that we might see on the iPhone 14, or at least the iPhone with the 48 megapixel camera, maybe the 14 Pro or the 14 Pro Max, one of those two. Another thing we should be expecting is the notch finally disappearing from the iPhone 14 lineup. This is something that I wish we saw on the iPhone 13 series, but all we got was a slightly smaller notch. Many analysts are pointing to this being how the iPhone 14 would look like. As you can see, it's a pill-shaped cutout, and you know, they're making it look like an Android device now, I guess. But you know, I don't think Apple would do such a thing. In fact, I don't think Apple would ditch the notch, because I mean, I bought a new MacBook and they added a notch to the MacBook. I don't think they had any reason to add a notch to a laptop, because why did they add a notch to a laptop? You don't need a notch for a laptop. Granted, Apple reduced the bezels on the new Macs, yeah, but in my opinion, I think they wanted something to make their laptops stand out, so they had to put that intrusive notch there. Anyway, I just hope nothing too weird like a small notch happens to the iPhone, or it comes with the same notch as the iPhone 13. That would just be weird. 9to5 Mac, which is also a credible source, gives us the possibility of seeing not just a pill-shaped notch, but also a separate hole punch camera, you know, in addition to the pill-shaped notch. This is because of the Face ID and all the sensors under Face ID under the camera. And speaking of Face ID though, the under camera detection where your Face ID is under the screen may not likely come this year or even next year. However, I'd like to know what you guys' thoughts are. Which one do you think will come on the iPhone 14 or the 14 Pro? Will we get a regular notch? Will we get a pill-shaped notch, pill-shaped cutout? Let me know what your thoughts are in the comment section below. I prefer a pill-shaped cutout, but we might not likely see it. Now to some Samsung updates. First off, it seems like there's a set date for the S22 series of devices to launch. Now, according to TechRadar and Digital Daily, which is a South Korean news website, the launch date for the S22 series seems to be the 8th of February, and people can start ordering the device or pre-ordering the device on the 9th of February. Shipping to pre-ordered buyers, people who pre-ordered, will begin on the 21st of February, and general sales should begin on the 24th of February. Anyway, guys, this seems like the most credible source, but you should take all what I'm saying with a pinch of salt. Don't take it as true. And as far as specs though, for the S22 Ultra, Android 12 is looking highly likely. Qualcomm Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 chipset as well, 12 gigs of RAM, and some other interesting specs are considered in the mix. Sam Mobile, which is also a credible source, they shared a screenshot of the Geekbench score for a new mystery device that people think is the S22 Ultra. They shared this Geekbench score on the 14th of January. Just like the S21 Ultra, the S22 Ultra should also support the S Pen, and some of the designs floating around make the S22 Ultra look flatter on the back, with only the camera being the bump on the back section, as opposed to the whole camera bump thing like the S21 Ultra. But again, guys, please grain of salt, take it with a grain of salt. Nothing is confirmed yet. I'd love to know what your thoughts are on this design, and also what your thoughts are on the specs of the S22 Ultra. How do you see the S22 Ultra looking? Still on Samsung's case, one of the goodies that came out of CES 2022, what CES brought us, is the Freestyle. It's basically a projector slash smart TV slash speaker all-in-one cylindrical shaped device. The projector adjusts the viewing angle with some sort of AI or auto projection, and you can even beam it to a ceiling, beam it to a plain wall, beam it to anywhere, and it will adapt and adjust to the wall and the color of the wall. Although it's a 1080p projector, that small size makes it look really cool. And hopefully it's something I can get my hands on to test here in the studio and review on the channel. Moving on to the Google side of things, if you've been following the mobile tech space, you probably would have seen Google working on their own foldable device. I won't blame you if you don't know that, but a lot of the updates from their new software, Android 12L, also has Google thinking of building for larger screens. 9to5 Google also reports that they've discovered some new animations for the unreleased Pixel foldable device. Again, grain of salt. Many of the sources claim that the Pixel Fold would look more like the Oppo Find N rather than the Samsung Galaxy, Z Fold 3 and stuff like that, in that it's much shorter with a slightly better viewing angle. The release timeline for a Pixel Fold looks highly likely to fall in the second half of 2022. That would be interesting to see a foldable smartphone from Google themselves, in the Pixel line. Do you think it would take on, maybe the Samsung Galaxy Fold? Would it take their market share? Would it challenge it? That's something to think about. That's something I'm interested to know. But I don't know if it is even likely to fall in this year. And I really love to hear you guys' thoughts on a foldable Google Pixel. All right, let's look at Nigeria. TECNO just launched or just released the POVA 5G. And it's a 5G-enabled TECNO smartphone. If you're a Nigerian like me, you probably already know that MTN, the largest telecom service provider, has acquired a 5G license. So maybe right timing for TECNO. That aside though, TECNO is launching a new telescopic macro lens. The lens would basically protrude or like zoom out from the back to take a photo. It's a 5x optical zoom that can capture images like the main camera sensor would capture images. No specifications have been released yet by TECNO, and it's still a concept, it's still in concept phase. Another thing TECNO is working on is an Android phone camera with sensor shift, something similar to what the iPhone 12 Pro Max and 13 have. The idea is where the sensor sort of moves instead of the camera's lens for stability while recording video, which is the best way to do it. They want to be the first Android phone to do this, and that's kind of a tall fit. What do you guys think though? Do you think TECNO will be the first to do this? TECNO will be the first to bring sensor shift to Android? Let me know what you guys think. As it was announced, and as many people know now, Nigeria has unbanned Twitter. If you want to know what happened, I made a video about why Twitter was banned. You can watch that with the card up above and or the link in the description below. I'll leave a lot of links in the description below to sources of all what I mentioned, by the way. But right now, the app is unblocked from Nigerians. Nigerians don't need to use a VPN to access Twitter anymore. Can use it freely. A lot of people seem to think it's because of the upcoming elections. A lot of people claim that certain conditions have been met indoors or behind closed doors. The answer can only be discovered in the coming months. One thing is for sure, it's been quite a different 222 days since Twitter was blocked or banned in Nigeria, where a large number of people had to resort to using VPNs to access the service. Anyway, I really like what this VPN provider did with their meme here, where they said Nigerians are now throwing their VPN into the trash. But how about you guys? Were you kind of stuck? Did you like leave Twitter like some people? Did you not log on Twitter anymore after the ban? Or were you using a VPN? Let us know in the comment section below. That's pretty much it for this video, guys. Do let me know what your thoughts are about all of the new tech we've mentioned and all of the gist we've brought. And also let me know if you guys like this video format. Is this something that you would love me to keep doing on the channel, where I do like a recap of tech through the week? Let me know, as I'd love to do more of this informative type of video for you guys. All right, thank you so much for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next video.